You know it's going to be good when Nick Rabar is here in the kitchen. Avenue N is the place. Summer bouillabaisse with tomatoes and late harvest ramps are on the menu. What is a bouillabaisse?
Yes, sir. Well, all right. So a bouillabaisse is like a seafood stew.
Okay.
Okay, and it originated in France, and it's been done every way you could possibly imagine. And in France, where its origins come from, they used some very fun fish. They used sea robin and monkfish, and a lot of the cooks that were creating this dish would sort of use what was available to them.
So we got a bunch of stuff here. So what do we need for this
one? Got a bunch of stuff here. We're going to do lobster is going to be our primary. We've got some Gulf shrimp. We've got some beautiful local little neck clams, some mussels. And then what we're really going to do today is add in a bunch of fun vegetables, okay? Traditionally, see, we've got our potatoes simmering away here.
Right.
Potatoes are very traditional.
Just regular potatoes, right?
These are little tiny marbled Yukon gold potatoes. Okay. They're going to be bite-sized and perfect. We have fennel, also very common. Mm-hmm. But then we're going to do white beans. We've grilled some artichoke hearts. We have some ramps. We have some celery. We have beautiful chive blossoms. And what we really have here, Will, which I'm completely ecstatic about.
I love these tomatoes.
Finally, they're here. So these are local sun golds, and we are getting some of the first tomatoes of the season right here in my hand. They were actually the first pick from my friend Leanne over at Indie Growers.
Delicious, delicious.
Thank you, Leanne, for those. And this is going to be absolutely unbelievable.
Sounds good to me. Yeah. We will put this together, talk to Nick about what's going on at the great restaurant, Avenue N. Back to you. You want great food? Avenue N is the place. You want a great chef? Nick Rabar's the guy. We got summer bouillabaisse, tomatoes, and late harvest ramps on the menu. This guy can't stop. He's already like working like a maniac.
I gotta go. He's got stuff to do. The clock is ticking, Will. And if you want great food, you come here to the Rhode Show sometimes too, right?
That we do.
This is beautiful. In the pan right now, I've got onions caramelized. I'm using Vidalia onions. All right, they're starting to pop. Plenty of them to get right now. They're so much sweeter. They caramelize so much faster. I've got celery. I've got fennel. All right? This is sauteing down, and this is so aromatic. This is the base of almost all bouillabaisse. Mm-hmm. Remember what I said. Bouillabaisse is a great opportunity to add things that you want to add. There's kind of rules, but there's sort of not.
Yeah, there's many different things that you can put in. If some of the stuff that you see here you don't really care for,
that's
something
right.
else.
Absolutely right. And that's why we're going in with some of these beautiful ramps right here.
Good.
The ramp is like the baby. It's like a small onion. It's an onion family, like a small wild leek. All right, these are coming from upstate New York right now. Okay. The end of the season on those. These are kind of on the big side, but still have that beautiful spring flavor. We're going to go in with some of these grilled artichoke hearts. Yep, so a fresh artichoke heart always. And then I took it down and I marinated it and I grilled it this morning. So we're putting in a ton of great stuff here. And then the key is with a great bouillabaisse is making sure all of your seafood cooks at the same time. So what we're going to do first is when this caramelizes just a touch more, we're going to go in with our clams.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to go in with our shrimp. And then we're going to go with our mussels, and then we're going to go with our lobster. The reason is the clams are going to take about 10 to 12 minutes to open up.
Right.
And they're going to release some of that beautiful clam stock right into it. And I've also made this beautiful lobster stock from the lobsters that I cooked off this morning. So many different flavors here. We're going to serve this with some beautiful Durham bread.
Looks good.
That I got from my neighbors over at Seven Stars. We have some Rui. We have saffron. We have everything going on here.
He's crazy about bouillabaisse.
I am crazy about bouillabaisse. And you know what, Will? I got to tell you something.
Yes.
Funny you should say that. I'm not always crazy about dishes that everything gets thrown into a pan and stew together, because I find that sometimes everything kind of tastes the same. This is not going to be the case here. All of these flavors have such strong independent properties.
Okay.
Shrimp and ramp and lobster and clam. These beautiful little potatoes that we sort of par cook that are going to go in here right now.
All right, so you're going to put those in.
Everything.
We are going to put this bouillabaisse together. Nick will keep cooking.
Yes.
We'll talk about the restaurant.
I will keep cooking, Will.
He's a busy guy.
You got to keep cooking.
He's very busy. Back to you. Nothing but trouble here. Nick Rabar, Avenue N, summer bouillabaisse, tomatoes, late harvest ramps. That is what we are making.
Yes.
This right here.
Yes.
No, is a triangle of trouble.
Look out.
This is the triangle of trouble.
But this is where we exonerate ourselves in this pan right here, which you can see is like popping itself up.
It's culinary exoneration.
It is complete culinary exoneration.
Let's do it.
And let's take a peek at what we have in this pan right now. So this dish takes a little bit of time. So while we were away, I threw in the seafood. So I have the shrimp, which you can see are poaching themselves up beautifully.
Look at that.
We have the clams that are now opening. Mm-hmm. We have the stock that is now simmering and thickening up slightly. All of these flavors are working so well together. So another thing that I did while we were away, Brendan, is I toasted some of this crostini right here, which I'm going to ask you to gently add on.
Are you allowing me?
Yes, you're going to do some work today, buddy.
Oh, man.
We've all got a job.
You're
going to
do a sample for me.
Yeah, so you're just going to kind of gently, there's a lot of holes in this. It's beautifully proofed Durham
brand. So that's what you're looking for.
Yeah,
right,
just
there.
Give me a little bit of that
Ruiz. Right, over here.
Yes, that's your world. That's your world over there.
Don't worry about this.
Yes, sir.
Traditional bouillabaisse is served with the crostini. The crostini generally is rubbed with this condiment called Ruiz.
Got it.
Ruiz is one of my favorite condiments in the world. Again,
I didn't know you had a favorite condiment.
I do. Now you know what it is.
Now we know.
I like ramp chimichurri a lot also.
All right.
We're going to go with this here. So Ruiz is like you make a base almost like a mayonnaise. It comes from the egg yolk and the olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
And then you add a little cayenne pepper, some garlic. I put a touch of anchovy in there. These things are fabulous, fabulous, fabulous ingredients. And I also put a touch of roasted red pepper.
Sounds good.
One of those condiments that you can sort of not, you know, make your own way. Ruiz is what it is. But, this looks just so amazing.
Use for a bunch of different things.
You can use it for everything. Panini, sandwiches, just put it on toast. You can omit the anchovies.
Okay.
You can add a little bit of extra everything. I'm going to put in some of these white beans,
mm-hmm.
which I soaked overnight and cooked this morning. Okay?
Yep.
And then I'm just going to add the tiniest bit of butter because we want this to be brothy. Yeah, you can go right in with a little bit of that, Will.
Just a couple of these things.
Be careful there, big fella.
All right.
So now, I'm going to pop that lid on that,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to let this go for just one more minute.
Let it simmer away.
Let it simmer.
And for Nick.
Well, that is...
I tried.
And I mean, you did pretty well.
Look at that. I was trying to make a giant one, but
now you got
to
make an R.
I realized I wouldn't be able to lift the two plates together.
That
anyway.
Says love. You're very romantic.
Don't worry about the W. Don't worry. I got that done, too. Don't worry, big boy.
You got away. Okay, so while this is simmering, can we talk about the restaurant?
If we must.
Hustling and bustling in Rumford.
Ooh, we've been jamming lately. It's the greatest feeling in the world. Thank you to everyone that comes out and supports us at Avenue N on a regular
basis.
That's
me. I'm there regularly.
Including you guys.
Yes.
And I had the privilege of having Will in last week, which is very special.
Right.
And Kirby, you're there with me frequently.
I think we should name one of the stools that should have a plaque on it.
Done.
Just throwing that out there.
Just consider it done.
But the atmosphere is always great, all kidding aside. Tremendous ambiance.
Thank you.
The food is always spectacularly delectable.
And is this something on the menu now?
No. I like to come here on the road show.
Do that for you.
It is. I like to come here and just share very appropriate recipes that I just absolutely am in love with. Of the moment, of the day, and I, you know, and let the food that I get sort of is what drives what's on the daily specials or what's on the menu or what we're doing here in the roadshow. So I can't believe how special it was to grab some of these First Harvest tomatoes. We're literally one of the first people in the state of Rhode Island to have locally grown tomatoes. The season is here.
This looks like summer.
This looks like summer. You know, and summer's right around the corner, but there's so much chatter about it lately that I just wanted to do something that represented the season. And I mean, this smells so good. The aromatics in there, you know, you can add wine if you want. You can add anise liqueurs if you want. I got my flavor from the fennel and the saffron. And just look at that.
I was going to say, because we've cooked stuff here in the Roadshow Kitchen, seafood in the Roadshow Kitchen before, and it's had a real, you know, you cook fish, you cook something like that, it's very strong.
Yes.
This isn't at all. You smell all of the other ingredients that you put in there.
Yes, and that's what I love so much about this. So I charred up, I raced out to the grill, and I charred up some ramps, which we're just going to put on there for garnish.
Look at that. I mean, come on.
And then a couple of these are what's called chive blossoms
and they're
here.
Good.
They're real good.
They're really good.
They're super strong.
Is that not a masterpiece, Will?
They're super strong.
And have you had one of these?
I have.
Yeah,
there's several of them. Go ahead.
And then I've got these celery blossoms also. So.
All right, this is the man, Nick Rabar. Thank you so much, buddy.
Let's pop a couple of these there. These just work
apart. If you would like to learn more about Avenue N, maybe learn about this new shirt he has on here, just get all the details at roadshow.com.